benefit to us using an autonomous mode for the existing agricultural fields. My name is Isaac. This is Jeff. That's Sean. That's Dan. Our faculty advisor for this project was Professor Satya, and our industry mentor for this group was Nathan Dorn, CEO of Foodlot.
The agricultural industry is a major economic factor in Monterey County. It attributes to over 18.5% of the total economy, brings in over $8 billion, and provides more than 76,000 jobs. Our motivation with this was to reduce the difficulties and stresses from growing crops, one of which is such as crop inspection. Crop inspection is really time-consuming and laborious, and it can be broken down into five stages throughout the growth cycle of a crop. The time that it takes depends on the field size and the crop that's being grown. Our goal was to develop a prototype of a navigational control that could be used to track down lines such as the row of crops. It was also to develop a system that was scalable, reusable, and could be integrated into already existing hardware solutions, such as the food origin vehicle, which you can see on the screen. And our hope with this was to advance the agricultural industry by implementing autonomous solutions. By doing so, you lower the cost of production, which lowers the cost of consumption, making things cheaper for you in the long run.
So the approach to our solution had a bunch of small but very discrete steps in order to reach our goal. So the first of which is the scope. In order to fully succeed in our project, we had to understand what we actually had to do. Our very first scope was to implement this solution on a Jeep-sized agricultural vehicle that was pretty much entirely written in assembly. And we wanted to make a Maps user interface in order to see where the robot is at any given point in time. Now, we realized due to cost and time constraints that was not going to be possible. So we made a more refined scope that would focus more on getting the actual computer vision working and the more important goals of this project, which is overall functionality. So during the design stage of our solution, we had to design a test rig that we could manually operate to test our camera. We decided to use a PVC structure for this test rig because then we could change it really easily if something was wrong with it or it didn't quite fit the model of a real agricultural vehicle. And as for the electronics, we did a bunch of research and chose to use the OpenMV camera module and the particle cellular module. We chose these modules because they came with a lot of preloaded functionality that we needed in order to succeed in this project. Also, we put a bunch of LEDs essentially to help us debug our project as we went along because we didn't want to rely on one module working versus another. And then the most fun stage, building. We got to take our cool designs and all of our hard work and make it physical and something we can actually play with. And the chassis was actually a lot of fun because we got to go to Home Depot and put it all together, put wheels on it, and roll around with it. And for the electronics, we had a really great time seeing how the camera would just work and how all the lights would start blinking when we started to do things. So that got us really excited for the development stage. So during the development and integration stage, we did a lot of iteration over computer vision algorithms. We wanted to find the most computationally efficient and tweakable algorithm because this is going on a very small piece of hardware that runs on a very even smaller CPU. So we had to really make sure that it was going to run fast enough for our purpose. We also designed and built a very focused user interface that's simple to use for farm hands or any type of operator that might need to control the vehicle. And as you can see on the right here, this is a map of our integration. So this project was entirely around a huge network of networks. We had a network of hardware and a network of software that all had to communicate with each other and in sync. So this was the major challenge of our project. But once we got it done, the results were really good.
So in the end, what were we actually able to deliver? We developed a camera system which will follow a straight line and output the degrees off center. We developed a web application designed to be used by a vehicle operator that will let them know when the vehicle has stopped or run into an obstacle. And we integrated wireless connectivity to our vehicle, which will communicate to our web application via cellular network. Here's a demonstration of our vehicle going. The LEDs in the front of the vehicle demonstrate the various signal outputs. You will see a white light blink in just a moment. That is indicating that the vehicle is slightly going off course and it is cranking itself. And now the red light at the end shows that the vehicle has reached the end of the line. So, future work for the project. What is still left? We eventually like to work with a group of engineers that would develop and integrate the vehicle dynamics to actually get it going. Future testing and improvements on the already existing prototype. And finally, to interface with the existing vehicle.
So first off, we'd like to thank Food Origins for being our sponsor for this project. Starbucks for our coffee to get through the project. The Student Center pool table to just be an outlet to just blow off some steam. And of course, Professor Paige White for our support.